Hey guys, Bill here. You know what I've been wondering about lately? What is the biggest fish in the world? Well, if you spend any time asking around, you're gonna find out that just about everybody in the world agrees that it's this thing called the whale shark. But what is a whale shark? I mean, is it a whale or is it a shark? And exactly how big is it? Is it a man-eater? I don't know. So I've come here to Mexico, where every summer they have one of the biggest gatherings of whale sharks in the world.
Today I'm boarding an actual research boat headed out to do a survey of the whale sharks. My hosts are two world-renowned marine biologists.
Hey, I'm Simon Pierce, and I'm a whale shark scientist based at the Marine Megafauna Foundation in the US.
I am Rafael de la Parra. I am a marine biologist, and I am devoted to the whale shark research and marine ecosystem north of Isla Mujeres.
There are some other tourists like me on the boat, and like me, they help pay for the cost of the research. In exchange, we get to tag along with the scientists as they survey and document the whale sharks.
Go!
All I can say is, holy moly, these things are like a bus going by you underwater. It's pretty scary at first, but they don't seem to be interested in us for lunch or anything like that. The whale sharks look like they're going really slow, but it's actually really hard work to keep up with them. The way it moved reminded me of my original question about these things.
Is it a whale or is it a shark?
Yeah, they've got such a confusing name. So they are a true shark that just acts a lot like a whale, and they're really big. So the whale shark's by far the largest fish in the world. The biggest that was measured was 20 meters long and 34 tons in weight. We think they live to about 100 years old, so they're one of the most longest lived of all fish as well.
Are whale sharks dangerous?
Whale sharks eat little stuff. So here they're gorging themselves on fish eggs. They've only got tiny little teeth, so they're actually suction feeders, so completely harmless to people.
But what if you're like swimming by and, you know, your leg happens to be near that huge open mouth? Is your leg gonna go in there?
Yeah, it looks fairly intimidating, but it's funny here. Sometimes you'll see them taking a little bit of seaweed. They'll just look confused and then spit it back out. So they're really selective about what they actually take in.
Simon and Rafael take lots of pictures of the whale sharks to help them identify the individual whale sharks.
Around the world, we've identified just over 5,000 whale sharks, but we think there's probably a few more than that, so I'm guessing maybe in the low tens of thousands.
They also tag them with satellite communications equipment to track their movements. Whale sharks have very thick skin, and that helps the scientists take skin samples without causing any pain or injury. From these skin samples, they can tell what the whale shark eats and if it is being affected by water pollution. They could also examine the DNA of the fish. Whale sharks are so big they don't have any serious predators, but they are considered a vulnerable species. The two things that threaten them the most is fishing and big cargo ships.
So one of the major threats to whale sharks here is clearly when you swim with them, they get hit by large boats. And this right here, we can see the problem. There's a really large vessel coming really close to the whale sharks and all the tourists swimming in the water too. Well, the sharks just can't get out of their way fast enough. So if they get hit, they get smacked by the propellers and they just sink and die. So the only ones we see are the survivors that have got horrible lacerations and just mutilated for life.
An effort spearheaded by Rafael has convinced the Mexican government to approve the placement of a maritime buoy where the whale sharks congregate. In the future, ships will be legally required to go around the sharks. There's also a plan to use their data to get this area declared a World Heritage Site, which would offer the whale sharks here greater protection.
Wow!
That was pretty spectacular.
Never encountered fish like that before.
Huge.
I think there was 30 or 40 sharks out there today.
Yeah. Yeah. Oh, incredible.
I mean, I'm not gonna forget that.
Nah.
For a long time.
Fins everywhere.
Thanks. Thanks for having me on.
No worries.
Okay.
Take my word for it, getting up close and personal with a whale shark is a once-in-a-lifetime experience. If you think you might want to try something like that, I'm going to leave a link in the description box that'll hook you up with the people who hooked me up.